shopping destinations. The trail map. Steep and deep powder run. The mountain nightlife. The terrain park. Skiing tips, snowboarding tips. Mountain history.
Our village on a mountain is designed to satisfy the...
Today, Slopestyle Television travels to Calabogie Peaks Alpine Resort. Located 80 kilometers west of Ottawa and 390 kilometers from Toronto, Calabogie Peaks is one of the largest ski resorts in eastern Canada. Founded in 1970, the resort is named after the nearby community. The mountain has a top elevation of 1,266 feet and a vertical descent of 761 feet, for a total of 69 skiable acres. The 29 runs at Calabogie can be broken down into the following: 40% intermediate, 30% beginner, and 30% expert. The lift system features two chair lifts and one carpet. On today's episode of Slopestyle Television, we fly into Ottawa and travel to Calabogie Peaks during its big annual Mardi Gras party. Wild costumes, dummies, liquor, and dozens of crazy people trying to ski across a giant hole in the snow filled with ice-cold water. The locals call it the Puddle Jump. And let me assure you, the crashes are fantastic. We do a few laps through the park with the talented Calabogie freestyle ski team, Angle Large. Later, we shall meet an amazing sit skier. It's skiing and snowboarding Ontario style. On Slopestyle. The journey for Slopestyle Television starts in Toronto, with a short flight east, to Ottawa. Making the journey for Slopestyle is Chris Jacobs.
All right, another week, another airport. We're here this week in Ottawa, going to check out Calabogie Peaks.
I got words for you. I got a job to do. And no, you ain't gonna slow me down, because I ain't gonna be around. I know that's hard for you. I got plans to do.
All right, we just landed at Ottawa International Airport. It's kind of a cloudy day out there, about minus eight. It's a short drive, and we'll be at Calabogie Peaks.
Hello and welcome to the top of Calabogie Peaks on this beautiful Sunday morning. I'd like to now walk you through the mountain and show you all the features we have here, the trails at Calabogie. Let's begin over here on the west side of our mountain, and where we have our green terrain coming down what we call the old K&P. As you come down to the bottom of old K&P, you'll see we have two chairlifts. One is called Solar, and one is called Lakeview. Lakeview because it's near the mountain. We also have a lovely beginner bowl terrain over here, and it's a carpet lift that serves both the beginner bowl and three or four lanes of fantastic tubing. The classic run and the most skied run here at Calabogie is Shantyman, and it comes right down through here to the bottom. About half of our customers ski Shantyman all day long. As you come to the center of our mountain, there's the famous Bear Chute and the Face of Tiger right here in the center. This is one of the biggest, steepest drops in Ontario. This will challenge the best of skiers. And then finally, another great cruiser for families and new skiers called Black Donald's, way over here on the east side of the mountain that comes right back to the lifts. Another great place for people to take their green skills and move it up one notch to a blue trail. And our hotel and our base lodge is down here at the bottom.
I like to party.
All right, well, we are here at Calabogie Peaks. We're the Calabogie Freestyle Ski Club. And we got a few guys here. We're gonna hit lots of jumps and we're gonna hit a few rails. And we're gonna start with some rails right now.
At Calabogie, many of the local teenagers come up to the hill day after day, grinding out rail after rail. It's a perfect example of the locals making the most of the conditions at hand.
How are the rails feeling here, guys?
Sick.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Super smooth.
Smooth?
Flips, fives, threes, sevens, rodeo flips, everything. We got so much going on here, I can't even remember it all.
And things. Awesome day.
How you guys doing?
Great.
Well, thanks so much for filming with us today.
Thank you for filming us.
Yeah, it was awesome.
Yeah.
Thanks, guys.
We'll catch you next time.
Yeah.
All right.
All right, here's the events team. They're all diligently waiting the first run down. How's the anticipation? How's the stoke?
It's crazy! Ah!
Old John Clark preacher's son preached all over the plain.
The only text we ever knew was hello, Jack and Gary.
You can do it, Will! How did that feel?
That's chilly.
Nobody has made it yet. I'm predicting today no one's going to make it. We'll see what happens.
Let's see.
How's the experience?
That's cool.
Good times?
Oh, great times. Cold, wet. Going back to work.
What's the secret?
Secret's just going for it, you know? You just gotta go fast.
I'm burning. I'm literally on fire. We gotta watch Nick though.
What's going on here, fellas?
What is
I'm happy you asked. We're having a little bit of après-ski at Calabogie Peaks.
This is how it's done in Eastern Ontario. It may not be the Big West, but this is the Big East. We're having a good time, enjoying the day.
Something's going on over here.
Holding true to my people.
Hold true to your people.
True to my people.
Those are good.
Thank God for
that.
The Mountain Nightlife on Slopestyle Television. Presented by the award-winning Lighthouse Brewing Company. I can tell you, they make amazing beer. Coming up after the break on Slopestyle Television, we take a thrilling onboard ride with a sit ski. Then, we shall head back to the park to pick up a snowboarding tip. More Slopestyle TV, next.
Hey guys, Mac and Carol here at Calabogie Peaks, Ontario, in the heart of the Ottawa Valley. We got a beautiful day here today. We're going to do our cruiser tip on mastering the terrain. Alright guys, so mastering the terrain, it's pretty straightforward. We have to keep all our muscles moving, all our joints moving. We're talking about our ankles, our knees, our hips, our shoulders, everything like that. But more importantly, it's all about where we're looking. You look downhill, you look to see where you're going, you look at the snow, and then you're able to make your game plan. That way you're able to keep all those joints moving when they need to move and when they don't need to move. So we're going to head down here and we're going to give it a try. But remember, it's all about where we're looking. So when we're out there and we're encountering those bumps and those icy patches, those little piles of snow, or that beautiful groomer, we have to make some decisions out there. And by looking downhill, that's how we make those decisions. We keep looking, that's going to allow our legs to move when we need them to move and how we need them to move to make it all work well.
Yeah, snow. I don't know. I haven't seen this forward stuff in a while. But we're getting it. We've actually got lots this year. I mean, the amount of accumulation that they got this year here in Calabogie has been sick. But lucky for us, Calabogie here has got 24 cannons. Not snow guns, but cannons. And in one night, can they ever make a pile of snow? They have did a fantastic job this year. It's been great skiing right from Christmas. It's been awesome.
I guess it was 99. I was in a four-wheeler accident. I broke my neck. My name's Andy Van Grunsven. I'm a sit skier here at Calabogie Ski and Resort here, Calabogie Peaks. Sit skiing is, it's like skiing and driving. It's a little bit of an added rush being you combine the two together. And there's certainly a lot of adrenaline involved and a lot of freedom of ripping down the hill. There's probably skiers that are breaking 100 miles an hour, but I can get GPS on this small hill with a 210 downhill 70 miles an hour. So I'm sure that there's people going much faster than that.
Well, most people always wonder how the hell these things get on a chairlift. Well, I get asked that every little kid in the line behind in the morning. They're all, how do you get this thing on the chairlift? Well, this is how.
Whoa.
Just scoops me right up like that.
It was extremely difficult, I guess, was the draw for me. I spent 2 years of pretty much crashing every time. Well, if I got one run a day without eating it, that was something.
My God. We'll leave the rest of that off film, buddy.
Just training on this hill here in Calabogie, I went to Nationals, and I think I was sitting second in Canada after that. I went to U.S. Nationals last year, 36 sit skiers, and I think I came in sixth, I guess, with no training or no coaching or anything. So the nicest thing about Calabogie is it's got consistent runs that are challenging for me. I mean, it's not that big of a hill. We only got 700 and some vertical feet, but there's a consistent runs here of consistent pitch and fairly steep that I can work on everything I need to here. The other major advantage is during the weekdays, I don't know where everybody is, they must be working or something, but there's no one here on the hill.
Hi everyone, we're here with Slopestyle TV at Calabogie Peaks, just an hour outside of Ottawa. My name's Bowden, and we're going to be showing you today a 50-50 with the front one out. Alright, so we're here in the park, ready to try our 50-50 with the front one out. So as we approach the rail, we're going to approach from with the rail on our toe side, so this is going to be from our front side. And what we want to do is we want to really flex our knees to pop and be able to get up onto the rail in our balanced position. We have here a flat double bar urban setup rail. So there are a couple things you should be comfortable with before trying this. One would be a front one on a small jump. And the second thing would be 50-50ing a short urban rail like this. The key is to come in balanced and within our nice freestyle triangle position. even weight on both feet, our knees slightly bent, looking towards the rail. We're gonna pop slightly from one side of the rail, land on 50-50, and as we come to the end of the rail, we're going to look over our front shoulder and slowly rotate so that we come out with the front one. And then we're gonna land switch and ride away.
Coming up after the break on Slopestyle Television, Julie gives us a fitness tip on warming up. More Slopestyle Television after these short messages.
Hi, I'm Julie French. This is your Slopestyle TV fitness tip brought to you by the Victoria Athletic Club. Today I'm going to show you how to do a good warm-up to get your blood pumping, your muscles moving, prevent some injury when you're out there on the hills. Super important, you can do this anywhere. So anywhere meaning when you're in line for your tickets, when you're in line to go up the mountain, anywhere. So first thing I'm going to show you is speed skaters. Try to jump farther and farther each time. Pressing off that heel, just jump side to side. You can move your arms in here, get everything moving, whole torso, and that's a speed skater. Second one, jump squats. Sitting your butt back, chest up, and jump. Super easy. You can do both of these exercises anywhere. If anyone asks you what you're doing, tell them you're warming up, and maybe they'll do it with you.
The fabulous accommodation for Slopestyle Television provided by the Dixon Mana at Calabogie Peaks Resort.
Watching Slopestyle on Slopestyle.
I thought that show was great. Next time you film out there, call me, I'll go with you.
Oh, is that not supposed to go?